from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gitchagumi. The lake it is said never gives up the dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With the Lord of Iron Ore 26,000 tons more and the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty, that good ship and true was it born to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. The big freighter's gold, it was bigger than most, and the crew and good captain well seasoned. Doing some terms with a couple steel firms, and she left fully loaded for Cleveland. Later that night, when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? Sound and the waves broken over the railing, and every man knew as the captain knew too, the witch in November came stealing. The dawn came late, breathless and wet, when the gales in November came slashing. When afternoon came, he was freezing rain in the face of our hurricane west wind. Came on deck, sailing fellas, it's too rough to feed ya. At 7 p.m., the main hatchway caved in. He said, fellas, it's been good to know ya. The captain wired in, it's got water coming in, and the good ship and crew was a peril. Later that night, when the lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Waves turn to minutes, 2 hours. The mind speed up, or they might have capsized. The mind broke in deep into water. A further blow, Lake Ontario takes in Lake Erie, Kansas Center. Time must go, and the man is on the. It's a gale to November, remember. They pray in the Maritime Sailor's Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times. Reached man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. Legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gitchagumi. So there it said, never gives up the dead when the skies of November came early. Thank you.
Ha, ha, ha.